This is front camera. Great.
We want to do something for this. We go.
Comrades, if you have to the country, we know the country has not helped you, has not served you.
I don't know. Coming up. and position what encouraging, what encouraging habits study closely and even consider following. The next thing I knew, this movement had been hijacked by the very people who laid the foundation, and I'm not for it by the way, and the foundation for the collapse. They're forming coalitions. And I'm actually invited by one of the residents who I registered. Coalitions all over the place. Once again, confusing people, there's no beginning to be there. But those are what you trust.
Order, please, order, please.
The answer to that is very simple. Look at their track record. That's all. Don't allow yourself to plunge into a zone of amnesia in which you are convenient for young candidates under the same watch that they call themselves the God-designed, designated watchmen over the fortunes of this nation. And suddenly, there they are, and I see Nigerians walking to them and asking them once again to be. Oh, mind you, to say very clearly, if it becomes a political party, count me out, bro. That's already been done. Because they call themselves the violating appointed the guiding of this society, the divine the guiding. Watch them very closely. Watch their movements. And for heaven's sake, also grow up. And what do I mean by that? Why do you need patronage? Why can't a new order arise from this fashion? Why can't the new generation actually rise, throw us all out of the window, and take control of their own lives? Why do we keep recycling the same children, traitors, enemies of the people? Why do we need to go for blessing somewhere to make up your mind that it is time that you control your own existence? Why do you come to trust me? I don't understand. And that's why I use the expression, go up, for heaven's sake. Vigilant, and take your own destiny in your hands. Once again, I don't want to be misunderstood. I know what I think about this government. When voting time comes, I know exactly where I'm going to cast my vote. But I'm not going to allow anybody to open me and say, I will show you the path. So, this would be adding insult to injury. When I read that some people are supposed to have lights on their finger, in the hand of their fingernails, I said, yeah, that's probably true. But then what about those who are speaking? Haven't they waited in the blood of this nation? Aren't they responsible for the blood bath in this nation to be soaked? Did they contribute towards the predicament of this nation? The insecurity of life, the kidnapping, right, left and center of our children? Are they blameless? Now how can they now come and say that we can show you the way? That's the only message I have for you this afternoon under this scene. I'll go a greater length in this little publication that I'm sure comes out before too long for any of the publishers, as I said before, to be in honor, not just in honor of Gani's birthday, but to remind you of what is true, to remind you of what took him to Madrid Gashua or Washington, what took him to Kabila, whatever, or whatever, by the way, briefly, the government puts it right there. So, he's been through the furnace. I think some of us will be prepared. So, we walk along the only path, just a little bit, to achieve the molecule of that vision which he had given to Texas. Thank you very much. Thank you.
And then, please, officials, the chairman, please, would I do that in a moment?
Say that in a moment.
Would I do that in a moment?
Yeah.
on behalf of the Gani Fawehinmi family. Now for those who understand what Gani Fawehinmi was, is a man of cleanliness. I want to appeal to us that today's event is not just about merrymaking. There are a lot of our leaders here who have been built to bring to us. I want to appeal to us that we maintain the highest possible level of government so that we can have a good audience within the whole place. I want to appeal to us on behalf of the family that we maintain as much as possible silence here. Before I come over our guest speakers, who are going to be speaking to us for 5 minutes each, let me recognize briefly the presence of a member of the Labour State of Assembly who is here with us, Honourable Tunde Brahima. We have the Palm Niger Delta Forum, two leaders of the Palm Niger Delta Forum, Honourable is here with us. We have the Conference Pension here with us from Ireland. Let me also recognize the presence of Dr. Bunia Moshe in the mail. We are also the former member of the local, our home comrade, who is also here with us. Let me also briefly recognize the presence of Mr. Ray Ebu, who is within the hall. We also have our own Archbishop Richard Akinola in the hall. We also have Kaoru Lefosina here, and a lot of the Gani Fawehinmi alumni who are here with us. Let me just announce that while the chairman was speaking, the National Chair, National Conscious Party, came in, Dr. Humous. To speak to us for 5 minutes each, starting with the former governor of Kaduna State, Alhaji Barambe Musa. Let me invite to this side of the service table, Mr. Debuani Miro, from the Center for Anti-Corruption and Open
Thank you. Thank you.
will take over all those universities and libraries that were set up with public funds. And that will be sooner than you think. Very, very soon. That will be done. These are some of the struggles that Gani went. Luckily, Gani lost many cases on the ground that he had no local standard. But before he died, Gani won the battle for local standard. Today, and I also recall one case that Chief Fawehinmi handled for Professor Sheyita, the chairman, where the court said Professor Sheyita had no local standard. Today, sir, Gani developed law before he died, and our courts are now recognized public interest litigation in our country. Therefore, in honoring Gani on this occasion, we are challenged, particularly the young men and women here, to go out of this hall and get organized. And I think that the chairman has made. We need to get organized, we do not need to organize. We need to mobilize our people and mobilize ourselves to fight for a new Nigeria. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Next to speak to us is no other person than distinguished Senator Sheosani from Kaduna. We have within this house a lot of things. Nasrawale Okuni, the teacher of NIM.
I stand by the existing protocol. My revolutionary greetings to all the comrades on this table and the ones on the other side. Today we gather here to appreciate and accomplish the life of a patriot, a revolutionary, a nationalist, and an outstanding freedom fighter. One in whose struggle, in whose commitment and determination to open the space for democracy in Nigeria became power and foundation for why we are here. Gani Fawehinmi was not just an institution, he was a man who established institutions. We will never remain grateful for his struggle, for his sacrifice, for his commitment to the total liberation of our country. We must be very frank with ourselves. We are out of a military rule, but we are not here into a democratic Nigeria. In fact, our country is sick. The republic is sick. Our people are dying. Violence, bloodshed, killings, mass murder is becoming an emblem of our democracy today. It is unfortunate that the forces of freedom, those who have made sacrifices to free our country from military colonialism, they have taken a bad step. We are out of PDP in this room, but we'll be deceiving ourselves to say we are in the promised land. We are not in the promised land. We must keep preaching the revolutionary vigor, the revolutionary stupor, the revolutionary valor of our people must be kept alive. You must stand firm in the defense of democracy. The political ruling elite are not yet prepared to see the democratic Nigeria. Nigeria's political reality is about personal interest. It's about personal interest. Those who destroyed our country in the past are very much present as born again. We must be deceiving ourselves. You can't build a country because of an integrity of one person. Integrity of one person is not enough. Who does it? Integrity of one person. is not enough to sustain it. You need a chariot that is driven by a set of principles, set of revolutionary ideas that will transform our country. We have a president who is a man of integrity, but integrity is not enough for leadership. Leadership requires all other and several issues and qualities. Our country, future, it can. We must tell ourselves the truth. We must remain vigilant. 2019 is at hand. People who have proven integrity, who have offered themselves for office, please don't hold people because of their political parties. You have tried that for 20 years, it has not taken you anywhere. Hold people based on their individual quality, their commitment and determination to lead you away from where you are to be in the future. I thank you very much.
Thank you. Now, he is the president of the Human Rights for Change Initiative and Center for Change, former president of the Campaign for Democracy, and she is no other person than Dr. Joe Odeo Buhari. Women arise! Women arise! Women arise!
Revolution, man! Men arise! Quintessential real chairman of this vocation, who cancel all his appointments to honor Gani Fawehinmi. 10 years ago, when we searched Gani Fawehinmi before he traveled, he insisted that Professor Oshoyinka should deliver his 70th birthday. He did. But Gani had to speak with us from his hospital bed. I salute you, Chairman. Our own Mohammed, Mommy, Comrade Gani, Fawehinmi. I want to salute veterans of many progressive parties seated on the service table. And I want to especially greet everyone in the audience. We have gathered here today to honor a great life wire of the human rights and pro-democracy movement, Chief Gani Fawehinmi, who will have been 80 years today. Gani Fawehinmi lived his life for the masses, for justice, fairness, and equity. We have said lots and lots of things about Gani Fawehinmi. Gani Fawehinmi taught us to organize more and organize less. As we speak today, the befitting memorial we can give to the bulldozer of our struggle, to a leading light, is for us to imbibe all the virtues that Gani lived and died for. Nigeria is living under the heavy weight of corruption. If we not kill corruption, corruption will kill us. If we want to imbibe the virtues that we live and die for, we must stand firm for the fight against corruption. We must walk the talk. And we must also ensure that justice, fairness, and equity reign. I still want to use this occasion to call that a state of emergency must be declared within the security sector. In Bama, several people were killed today while they were praying. Life has become cheap, brutish, and hellish. We remember our brothers, sisters, and every other person. We want to use this occasion to sound a note of warning to Shekau. Ashekau was released, our mother's father and our brother. But the most important thing is that government must be proactive. Government must provide for the welfare of the people and security of our people. I want to say that women, we must use our numerical strength to assert ourselves. We are about 50% of the population, and at the National Assembly, in the Senate, we only have 7 women out of 107, and in reps, we have 15 out of 369. Women, nobody must use you as cheerleaders. It's so nauseating when I see women clap and you're following politicians. We must use our numerical strength to assert ourselves. And that is why each and everyone must register. We are fathers, we must be vigilant. We cannot be vigilant if we cannot exercise our rights through the ballot. That day will soon come, and all of us must get our voters card, and we must ensure we exercise our civic responsibilities. Finally, we want to say that we have the statue that was unveiled by Lagos State Government. We want to assure the family, Gani, and every other person. And I want to plead with our leaders here, if us to retire, we must put on, we must be ready to go back to the trenches. But anytime the oppressed people are gathered, Gani's shadow will always be ashamed. I want to salute each and every one. And I want to say that we must never let Gani, Gani Fawehinmi, and each of our leaders that have come, we must never let them down. Solidarity forever. Barrister, Basiras, and all the in-laws that are here. I want to tell you that for traveling far and wide from England, from USA, to show your solidarity, that Gani Fawehinmi will continue to live in the unconsciousness of our people. So Gani lives on. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. George. We appreciate it. We appreciate that. Before we take other remarks from our leaders and invited guests who are here, I want to invite the speakers to the next 5 minutes, the representative of Comrade Oshomole, Charlie, and the people, one of our guest speakers here, Maurice, he represented the Comrade Israel.
Isolato, Africa, whatever. The organizers of this event, in special way, our mother, Alaja Gani Fawehinmi, and the children of the iconic lawyer to come from Africa. On behalf of Comrade Sowore, I hereby register the solidarity and support for the activity marking the 80th birthday of a well-known revolutionary, dynamic, progressive advocate for the masses to have come from Africa, Chief Gani Fawehinmi. for comrades, as well as all of us by the labor movement. Our association with Chief Gani Fawehinmi is a total commitment, not partial one.
Snap.
Because Chief Gani practice the principle of trade union movement. An injury to one is an injury to all. Today, the opening standard of our national anthem says, "Arise, O compatriots, Nigerians, born obey." At the time, it was very risky. At the time, it was not fashionable to sing national anthem. Chief Gani Fawehinmi has been acting this anthem in practice because he stood for justice as a compatriot wherever he has seen justice. And you know that Chief Gani has gone in and out of prison as far back as 1960 down to 90s in fighting for honors. This was a great lawyer who had handled many cases, as Femi Falana pointed out. But for Chief Gani Fawehinmi, he was not just interested in cases or judgment, but he was more interested in justice. But even at that, in one landmark judgment that are very, very important for Nigerians. Today, we freely register political parties. It was Chief Gani Fawehinmi who went to court to break the back of the island in dictating to Nigeria three political parties. He got a Supreme Court judgment that enforced the spirit and content of the 1999 Constitution that says that Nigerians have the right to form political parties. In 2003, there were only three registered political parties. But when Gani went to court, insisting that ACP should be ready, that's how today we have close to 70 political parties today in Nigeria. Then, as I said this morning, we freely now go on strike, on protest. Even in a democracy, we have the likes of President Olusegun Obasanjo, who acted like a civilian dictator, who went on to stop Nigerians from protesting against arbitrary increase in price of petroleum products. Chief Gani not only joined us, but he went to court to enforce our right to go on strike and to go on protest. Please, help me give me a round of applause. He also published a book which shows the increase in the price of fuel of comfort. My last comment is that Lagos State Government today did a very good job to build a befitting status in honor of Chief Gani Fawehinmi. And please help me clap for Lagos State Government for this honor. But my attitude to this is that if Lagos can do this, then the federal government of Nigeria should do far more better. If President Buhari can come to Lagos to declare open the bus stop without buses, I think we should tell President Buhari today to do the correct honor for Chief Gani Fawehinmi, and Chief Gani should be honored posthumously with national honor. I know that Chief Gani was once honored when he was alive by the late Yaradu, but he rejected it, which shows his selflessness. I think today, honoring Gani is honoring everything that he stood for: selflessness, sacrifice, and dignity for mankind. Our last comment, which Comrade asked me to repeat here, is that the best way we can honor Gani is to sustain his legacy, especially the struggle against corruption. And we need to ask ourselves, what would be Gani's reaction today? That with all the wealth of Nigeria, many of our people are still living below poverty line. Senator Sheu Sani just released to us how senators collect 15 million naira monthly. And when you look at my comrade senator, he doesn't look like somebody living on minimum wage. But what will be the reaction of Gani to that? That when few senators are collecting such amount of money, Nigerian workers are living on 18,000 minimum wage. What will be Gani to the disputed list of looters? APC is talking of one list, PDP say another list. I know BTs, you BTs, you wait for lab BTs. I think the way we can sustain Gani's legacy is to name and shame and damn corruption. Forward ever. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Comrade Sowore. Now, in the next couple of minutes, we shall be taking special remarks for just 2 minutes each from some of our leaders that have been selected to us here. And I will be starting with no other person than Dr. Femi Okuro, who is giving a special remarks in 2 minutes.
In the case of their Sharibu,
in the case of the 30 girls who are in now, that one girl who, because of her, they have been bruised on the knee, simply because of her religion. Whether we are Christians or Muslims, this is not concern to us. The Nigeria should not be subjected to prayer and unusual persecution simply because of Jesus and religion. And if this happens to Nigeria, it can happen to any other Nigerian. I wonder what all our pastors and reverends are doing. I think it is time all the so-called Catholic bishops, Pentecostal bishops, Anglican bishops, every bishop, every description. It is time they put on their hats off and march on the Buddha and demand the release of their people. And it's not only Christians who do it, it's Muslims who do so. Because if it can happen to a Christian, it can also happen to a Muslim. So these are all acts of bad governance Nigerians must show their displeasure. And as for the way forward, I agree with my colleagues who have said that there is no future in all these people parading themselves as the saviors. The future lies only with the youth. Even Buhari said that 70% of Nigerians are under 40. If that is so, I throw the net to those of us under 40 that the solution lies with us. It does not lie with your ambassadors. It does not lie with the Lopangitas. It does not even lie with the Derigianas and other politicians. The system lies with the youth today. Let the youth get themselves together and form their own political party. We need a political party formed by the youth, led by the youth. The youth with initiative, with family, with determination, with Nigeria. If they can do this, then I believe Nigeria has to. Thank you very much. Thank you. Just to make you realize that a lot of people who are participating in this event today have to travel to Lagos, and some will be willing to make their journeys back to their various destinations. We want to encourage our speakers to please keep to the 2 minutes time so that we can have as much as possible from the service they will speak to us. I'll be calling. Next we speak to us for 2 minutes is from the Kemi Abori Shadi.
The chairman, Voice of the Trainga, we thank you for the inspiration you continue to give us. My mommy, Mrs. Gani, my Apuro, Mo, Alhaji Balarabe Musa, the only Nigerian politician who became governor and remained materially poor. I bow. Senator Shehu Sami, we are talking with you that though PDP was defeated in 2015, PDP is still in power. There is no difference between the PDP and the APC. They have the same program. They share perspectives. They implement the same policies. Therefore, when we are looking for the way forward, it is not a question of Obasanjo versus Buhari. There is no difference between Obasanjo and there is no difference between Buhari and Jonathan. The chairman of today has put it absolutely, abundantly, that in our country today, there is a collapse of governance. There is failure of governance. Section 42B of the Constitution provides that the welfare and security assault on the welfare of our people. Today we have a president who went to London to receive a medical tourism, and recently he's blaming Nigerian youths for asking for free medical care. The Constitution is sworn to uphold, provide for free medical care. But this president is blaming Nigerian youth for asking for free medical care. We have a president today who sends his children abroad for education and is blaming Nigerian youth for asking for education, free education. Yes! For the youth to access education. We have a kind of free housing. Yes, the Constitution is sworn to uphold mandate government to provide social housing for the poor. Therefore, we have a president who came to power on the promise of uplifting the well-being of the people. But in power, his government, contrary to his electoral promises and contrary to the Constitution, is more to uphold. If Chief Gani were to be alive today, he would be on the streets protesting against Buhari. I know very well that at a point in time, he promoted Buhari, but Chief Gani live a life of principles. Once you deviate from the very angels of the people, Chief Gani Fawehinmi will not mind to fight you. Chief Gani Fawehinmi will be number one, protesting against the misgovernance, the killing, the poverty pervading the land in Nigeria today. The ABC government, led by Buhari, has an economic program. The name of that economic program is Economic Recovery and the Growth Plan, ERGP. That program is a declaration of war on the Nigerian people. That program seeks to provide education through the private sector. That program seeks to provide employment through the private sector. So we have a government that is promoting a fundamental paradigm shift from the public sector being the engine of economic growth to the private sector being the engine of economic growth. So the government we have today should not deceive us. This government exists only for the rich, for the capitalist class. The way forward, our best. Do we remember Chief Gani Fawehinmi? How best? One thing that was paramount to Chief Gani Fawehinmi was the call for the implementation of the social economic rights under Chapter 2 of the Constitution. The right to education, the right to medical care, the right to housing. And if any government is not providing or implementing this program, then that government is the enemy of the people. That government must be fought. Whether in the ABC or in the PDP, we must form a new political movement or form coalitions of movements that believe in the implementation of Chapter 2 of the Constitution as a minimum basis to allow anybody or any party to rule us in Nigeria. Thank you.
And the other person, Mr. Fire, who is for your welcome.
the first time from the Carnival Elite Chamber. The speech process for 2 minutes is the presidential hopeful and the publisher of Sowore Reporter, Mr. Omoyele.
Greetings, Nigerian people. I want to say, very briefly, that Nigeria must be regretting that when they had a chance to choose between Chief Gani, Fawehinmi and a Barabbas, Chief Olusegun Obasanjo, they decided to choose Obasanjo instead of choosing Gani, Fawehinmi, and that is what we are regretting today. I want to disagree openly with Senator Shehu Sonny that President Buhari is the man of integrity. President Buhari is not a man of integrity. He is a man. A president that cannot declare his assets is not a man of integrity. A man that is surrounded by thieves is not a man of integrity. So don't come and use some political correctness, which is only applicable to some people. I know you are a politician, but you are our brother. We must tell you the truth. And I have decided before you that what Chief Gani, Fawehinmi started and could not accomplish because it came before his time, we are going to accomplish it this time. We are sending President Buhari back to his area in Dawa from February 14, 2019. We are retiring all the thieves, whether they are based in Ota, or they are based in Mina, or they are based in Dawa or Kaduna, all of them are going to be retired. And I agree with Professor Wole Soyinka that it is time for our elders to retire and rest. And we use even a stronger word by saying that we should throw them out of the window. No, Professor, we are not throwing you out of the window. You are going to be with us. But some people within amongst your generation, we have to pay for the sins against the Nigerian nation. They are doing it right now in South Africa. Zuma is facing prosecution. They are doing it in South Korea. The woman who just left is facing prosecution. Right? They are also doing it in Brazil. Lula is going to start his jail term. There is no reason why the Nigerian president who looted and destroyed this country should not one by one go to jail. Properly prosecuted. And to our comrades, Shehu Sonny, you people that are loving allowances, we would like to abolish your allowances and eventually abolish your Senate, because the Senate is a waste of space. It has become a common of thieves. Can you imagine that in a country that Khalifa has been fought for, the Senate president is not Shehu Sonny, but a thief from Kwara named Nicola Saraki? It shall never happen again in this country that thieves will take over our country. And we say it in the name of Chief Gani, Fawehinmi, that we are taking Nigeria back next year. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Sowore. For the last 2 days, for the greatest Nigerian people, for you, thank you, Mr. National Chairman of ICP.
Nobody will be out. Nobody will be out.
soldiers who are on this side of the aisle and the civil defense sentiment on the other side of the aisle. I remember in nostalgia when our father, Godhead, ever resilient, ever faithful, ever passionate, ever compassionate, late Chief Abdelkadir Fawehinmi was speaking to us in the old Ubuah Hall in Lagos Hotel. He called everybody that was seated on this side. And when he called on me, he said, "Milu Satanko." I said, "Yes, sir." He said, "Don't let National Conscience Party die." He said, "Don't let the NCP die." And today, I can stand boldly in front of you to tell you that there is no other political party in Nigeria than the National Conscience Party. And I say this with tremendous fact. When people were talking, the people who gave birth to other political parties is the National Conscience Party. The National Conscience Party defended the interests of the child right as my father and of course in here.
Yes!
The National Conscience Party also went to court, up to the Supreme Court, to ensure that there is no registration of the National Conscience Party. And the National Conscience Party today is one of the former political parties in Nigeria. Not only that, we have 36 states of the Federation. In every state to go, the NCP reigns supreme because of our ideology and our belief. Ladies and gentlemen, you don't need to be hypocritical. The major legacy that Gani has left for us today is the National Conscience Party. And if it's so, when you come here in your large number in this hall, though you may have other political party affiliation, if you truly love Gani and you want to propagate the promises of Gani and you want to defend the interests of Gani, ladies and gentlemen, all of you should join the National Conscience Party. It is evidently clear that you have tested PDP, you have tested ABC. What is there for you as an option? The platform is free. If you do not believe in anything, believe in us. We are here to deliver to you. The country is now in total collapse as well. The promises that they have made for you with propaganda, they cannot fulfill it. The promises of giving you ABC, they have run away from it. The promises they have made that they are going to give you, make sure that your Gani and rice is equal to what you can afford, is no more there. What do you resort to? Ladies and gentlemen, let's start the revolution. Let's start the revolution by voting. Let's start the revolution by voting. Let's organize, not antagonize. Let's rearrange, not disarrange. Let's encourage, not discourage. Let's come together and get this country out of the wood. They have told you that you, young ones, are lazy. Are you lazy?
No.
Are you lazy?
No.
The only one with 15 million. When you do a statistic, the Nigerian youth are brought to up to 65 million. Let's say half of that particular position, that is 30 million votes for the candidate of the National Conscience Party. We will deliver this country out of poverty. And after all, the struggle of Gani is abolition of poverty. We won't abolish poverty in 2019. And the National Conscience Party is the gateway to achieving that. And thank you very much for listening.
Thank you, Dr. Sanko. In the next 6 minutes, we will end on this talk session. Meaning that, and the next 6 minutes, we'll be having for 2 minutes to speak to us, just the message. And the one will be the representative of the university, and I will be the last person to speak. But now let me give the microphone to the president of the campaign for democracy for 2 minutes.
Our unending crying for a Nigeria that is
want to have today democracy that Gani live and die for, things are not going the way Gani left them. So our bottom line today is, what is obtainable today is it what Gani fought and left us? It is not so. We must not retire. We must go back to the field and demand that all that Gani fought and died for, and some of our leaders seated here fought and remain, should be what we as a generation should go out and fight for. Democracy that Gani fought and died for is not this kind of democracy. So we as a people, the kind of Nigeria that we want to live, the kind of Nigeria that you will enjoy, I will enjoy, and the next generation will enjoy, is what Gani lived and died for. And with this, we shouldn't relent. We should go out, come out in mass, back to the field, and demand for some justice, and demand for the rule of law, and demand for equity and fairness within our democracy. Long live the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Greatest Nigerian people.
Thank you, President Ape, for democracy. Let me also recognize the presence of Barrister Gabriel Juma, the convener of UAD. You are welcome, sir. I want to invite you for 2 minutes to speak to us before I call on Honorable Tunde Ibrahima, who will be speaking on behalf of the Justice Government, the first senior advocate of Nigeria of the Gani Fawehinmi Chamber, Mr. Kayo Etiwo, SAA.
Nigerian people, Mr. Chairman, sir, I salute you and the very good Gani Fawehinmi family. By Gani Fawehinmi family, I do not mean mommy here or Mao or Masira, but the generality of the people that Chief Gani Fawehinmi identified with in his lifetime. As we all know, Chief Gani Fawehinmi was not a hungry man in his lifetime, but he identified with the hungry people. Tifani was not a poor man, but identified with the poor people. Tifani was not very young at the time he was dying, but he identified with the youth of Nigeria. I have a personal testimony that I started my practice under him at the age of 24, and he afforded me the opportunity to navigate the entire part of Nigeria up to the Supreme Court. So I was very flabbergasted when I read very recently that the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria referred to Nigerian youth as very lazy. I know Nigerian youth are very intelligent and very energetic. It is now for the Nigerian youth to decide for themselves whether they will continue to follow the one that regarded as being lazy, or they will chart a new course for themselves. Are you now going to continue to follow the one that regarded as being lazy? So there is the time for a decision, and the time has come. If Chief Gani Fawehinmi were to be alive, you probably have taken out a suit to challenge that statement. But you can use your vote to pass a vote of no confidence.
For 2 minutes, I have Dr. Obayas.
Greatest Nigerian people, join speakers before myself in saying that our message should be directed at the victims. Our message should be directed at the victims. There is no progress in Nigeria unless it is founded on self-liberation. Gani Fawehinmi has a vision. The right to healthcare, the right to education, the right to good life, the right to housing. The theme of this program, we are talking about effective governance. There cannot be effective governance unless the masses get the center. lazy to use our conscience and determine for ourselves what role we are going to play in mobilizing the victims. We must move our people to that stage of saying no more. That is my message. No more.
Enough is enough.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Enough is enough. It's the message. Enough is enough. It's the message. Mr. Gani.
Let us, Nigerian people. Let us, Nigerian people. Are you no longer interested in Nigeria?
Thank you. Let's go.
Over.
Let's go. 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 Let's go